I did wake up one morning after showering. I walked out into the hall by the closet, the one that housed the AC units and vents, and I heard this little rumble, like a small twiddling through some plastic bags. These are the bags, the ones that I had kept some nails and staples for lining my telephone and Ethernet. It was a possum. He was still alive, his nose twitching. No food, no water, scared, I'm sure, or perfectly content. And I'm no possum, so it was a little hard to empathize with its circumstance of being there all alone, no home or mother, some utility closet, just, you know, in a tool bag, or it was like a pet bag, I think. It was cold, and I called the maintenance guy in our complex, and I... lost, and I didn't mean any harm, and my cats were flipping out, and they were trying to claw under the vents. They were pawing at the door and chipping away at the wood, trying to get at it, sniffing, hissing, investigating, prowling, hunting, you know, the loneliness that they do. Another possum, the same size, same nose, identical in nature, but dead, I think. I'm no possum, but I do believe they are known to play dead in self-defense, but this one wasn't moving his nose like last time. Smelled dead. So surely it found its way or fell through the same gap and got trapped that was supposedly repaired in the utility closet. I mean, it must have fell down searching. Maybe smelled its mother or brother or sister or whoever was first discovered and caged and, I guess, released back into the wild. I figured the dead possum must have starved to death. This one, no food, no water. That's what happens to life when trapped in a utility closet and shut off from the world behind a closet for too long. You know, at least to this little guy, this moment of life. He was abandoned, he was forgotten, or maybe Kenny killed this initial possum and planted it there, the one that I originally saw, and it never got released when it was supposed to. You know, just to be cruel. Nah, I don't know. I mean, maybe not. I mean, these are the things I think of now. I pick apart like a detective. I analyze, you know, to keep me away from the image of her.